Ammonia will highly soluble in water. Approximately one volume of water can dissolve about 1000 volumes of ammonia at 273 Kelvin temperature. That means at 273 Kelvin temperature, one volume of ammonia can dissolve 1000 volumes of ammonia. So this is the reason why ammonia will have greater solubility character in water. Next, by dissolving it in water, it is going to produce OH minus ions. Due to the formation of OH minus ions, it works as weak base. Means ammonia will show basic character or basic in nature due to release of OH minus ions. When ammonia dissolves in water, it releases OH minus ions. Release of OH minus ions from ammonia indicates it works as Arrhenius acid, and that too it is weak base. We can show it as ammonia when dissolved in water H2O and produces NH4 plus OH minus. The basic character of ammonia generally results due to the formation of OH minus ions. So it works as weak base. Due to basic character, it forms ammonium salts. It forms ammonium salts like ammonium sulfate, ammonium chloride, etc. by reacting with acids. That means due to mild basic character or weak basic character, these base can easily react with acids and finally produces ammonium salts. Let us have one example. Ammonia when reacts with sulfuric acid H2SO4, it results as the formation of NH4 taken twice SO4, ammonium salts, resulting from when 2 moles of ammonia reacts with 1 mole of sulfuric acid. Similarly, when the same ammonia reacts with HCl, hydrochloric acid, it yields as the formation of ammonium chloride as our product. And next one more. As it is a weak base, it produces hydroxide precipitates of some metals from their metal solutions. So once again, what is our statement just now? As per the statement, when ammonia dissolved in water, it releases OH minus ions. So the release of OH minus ions is responsible for weak basic character of ammonia. So due to weak basic character, it produces hydroxide precipitates of some metal atoms, from their metal solutions. For example, zinc sulfate when reacted with ammonium hydroxide NH4OH. So remember, ammonium hydroxide is also called as dilute ammonia, because when ammonia reacted with water or soluble in water to produce ammonium hydroxide. So ammonium hydroxide in terms also considered as 1:1 ratio of ammonia and water is nothing but dilute ammonia. So that is also considered as ammonium hydroxide. Now this ammonium hydroxide is going to react with metal solutions, zinc sulfate in aqueous layer or aqueous condition. It reacts with ammonium hydroxide and produces zinc hydroxide. This zinc hydroxide will be expected as precipitate, and it is a white color precipitate, white PPT resulting from zinc sulfate and ammonium hydroxide. During this process, there is the production of ammonium sulfate, NH4 taken twice, SO4, by using 2 moles of ammonium hydroxide. Similarly, when the same thing, ferric chloride, when reacts with ammonium hydroxide, once again, aqueous solution of ferric chloride when reacted with ammonium hydroxide, it yields as the formation of ferric oxide dot XH2O. So this is a brown color precipitate. Plus ammonium chloride as side product. So this reaction indicates, due to weak base character of ammonium hydroxide, it reacts with some metal solutions and converts them into hydroxide, their respective hydroxide precipitates. Just observe here, zinc sulfate is a metal solution reacting with ammonium hydroxide. So this solution is converted into hydroxide precipitate. Similarly, ferric chloride aqueous solution when reacted with ammonium hydroxide, it yields us the formation of a brown color precipitate, which termed as ferric oxide Fe2O3.XH2O. So this is some chemical reactions expected from ammonia. And something more, due to presence of non-bonding pair of electrons, just we completed the structure of ammonia. So the structure of ammonia with pyramidal shape and upon nitrogen, so we generally use it to indicate with two dots, Lewis structure phenomenon. So the two dots indicates, these two indicates non-bonding pair of electrons, due to presence of these two electrons, which can be called as non-bonding pair of electrons, it works as Lewis base.